John 7:32. Ekusan hoi pharisaioi tu oklu gonguzontos peri autu tauta kai apestelan hoi archiereis kai hoi pharisaioi huperetas hina piasosen auton. Here Jesus is teaching in the temple at the Feast of Tabernacles, and we read, the Pharisees heard the crowd muttering or mumbling these things about him. And the chief priest and the Pharisees sent attendants, or in this case, perhaps officers, so that they might seize him. Now, when we hit that henna, you know the subjunctive is coming. Anytime you have an on, a e-on, a hatan, a hasan, a henna, you know the subjunctive is coming. It's either going to be a present or an aorist subjunctive. We see a sigma, it's going to be aorist. And that ending is third person plural. Notice also the lengthened vowel there that helps us know that's the subjunctive. This is from the verb piazzo, to seize, so that they might seize him. Auton is the direct object of the verb there. Let's go back here to the beginning. Let's look at this word oklu, right? To oklu. Why is that in the genitive? Well, that is in the genitive because your verb here, ekusan, takes a genitive object much of the time. Here's your subject, the Pharisees. The Pharisees heard, notice the lengthened initial vowel, notice the sigma. This is just an aorist active indicative, third person plural ending to match the third person plural subject. The Pharisees heard the crowd. We're not surprised that's in the genitive because the verb akouo frequently takes a genitive object. Then we have a genitive participle. It's a genitive masculine singular present active participle. Why is it genitive? Because it's describing, asserting something that the crowd is doing. It's matching the crowd because it's telling us about the crowd. The crowd is muttering or mumbling. They're mumbling these things about him, that is, about Jesus.